No.
A very good afternoon to one and all. I am sure the children would have enjoyed planting trees, and interestingly you will have to come and see whether it is growing properly, okay? Because you have tendered it now, you will have to see that it is tendered properly until it grows from a plant into a tree, okay? So you are happy? Very good. Thank you. Thank you. So may I now request the dignitaries please kindly take the stage. Dr. T.V. Venkateswaran, Dr. Sriram, and Dr. Velappan. Yeah. Before we commence the, I just request you to please either switch off your mobiles or keep it in silent mode. I request. Okay. May I now request all of you to rise for the invocation, please. I now request the chairman of the 80th CSIR Foundation Committee, Foundation Day Committee, Dr. K.C. Velappan, to welcome the chief guest and address the gathering. Dr. Velappan.
Anivarukkum, Pirpagal Vanakkam. Respected Director, CSIR CLRI, and respected T. Venkateswaran, scientist, the chief guest for this special event, especially for the Kendriya Vidyalaya students and fellow scientists, colleagues, students, dear friends, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the chairman and on behalf of the institute, I am welcoming you for this very special event for the children's science celebration function. This is very, very important. This type of event is conducted in CLRI, this is the first time. And very importantly, we are very happy our renowned scientist, Dr. T.V. Venkateswaran with us. He is a very famous person for science communications in our country. We are lucky enough to hear his speech. He is a very good academic program and research areas, history and popular science and science India. We are welcoming you, sir. For this afternoon, most of the students are very much enjoyed in the plantation as well as very particular to hear your speech because the title is that much creative thing. They will, based on that, they will take away many things. And very particular, this is a hybrid function, hybrid mode. Very limited because of COVID situation, direct CLR is very limited, permitted only to those who are staying in the campus. All others view in a virtual mode. In the end of this talk, those who are in the online mode, they might have sent some questions for your fine. You are requested to kindly answer for that. And if time permits, you can interact with as many number of students as possible. With these few words, just I am welcoming you again. I am requesting the Director CSA CLRI to formal welcome our guest with Angavastram. Sir, I would like to request our director for a few words about this occasion.
Dr. Venkateshwaran, my colleagues, all the children of CLRI family, it's been a great pleasure for CLRI that all we could assemble all of you here. A couple of days back, many of you people came to the school as though you are coming to the school for the first time. Had a wonderful drawing competition, essay competition there. You know why we are doing all this? Because we are getting you prepared to go back to school. In a few days' time, the government would say, goodbye COVID, back to school. So you guys must be ready to go to school, right? No more of virtual classes, no more of that, we'll slowly start getting prepared to go to school. Done? So everybody is happy to go to school or everybody is happy sitting at home? Happy to go to school? Yes. Great. Good.
I can't hear you.
Yeah. Okay. I will not go into introducing Dr. Venkateshwaran to you people because he will introduce himself when he speaks to you people. But I'll have to tell you something. I know him not through CLRI. I know him through my father. Dr. Venkateshwaran used to travel the length and breadth of the country. He used to go and meet specifically the children and talk to them various things so that what you read in the textbooks is made easy for you people. Okay? And now I know most of you people are very good in Google. You put all the questions that your teacher asks also into Google and take it out, right? So today evening, go and put yourself into the Google and look for some of his pictures. You can see him carrying a telescope and going around to see the stars also on specific occasions, right? So I will not take much of my time talking about all this. We will spend time listening to him. And of course, if you don't ask him questions, he gets angry. So, as he finishes his talk or in between his talk, whichever may be it, you will have to keep asking questions. Right? And that's what we are here for. That's one reason why we said this is hybrid, because if I put all of you people in front of the computer and him also in front of the computer will keep on talking and you will not be listening. So we changed the mode. We thought at least some of you should come here and listen to him. Okay? So we'll start off in that mode. Of course, take it from me, you guys all can understand English, but he can talk to you in English, he can talk to you in Tamil, he can talk to you in Hindi and many other languages that you people may not want to listen also. Fine? So there's no language barrier as well. Okay? So with that, I welcome Dr. Venkateshwaran to this stage. And let's all hear from him. And we'll try to make this program as frequent as possible so that you guys will all enjoy science. Right? Good. Thank you very much.
I request our director and the chairman of the organizing committee to take the seats in front of the dais so that we are ready for Dr. Venkateshwaran's presentation.
So while they are setting up, we will do one thing, okay? What is today? Today is the birthday of CSIR, right? So all the speakers before me told that we all belong to CSIR family. So this is the birthday of our grandmother, CSIR, 80 years old. So should we not sing happy birthday? Ready? Start. Happy birthday. Come on. Happy birthday to you. To you. Happy birthday, CSIR. Happy birthday to you. Right? CSIR was formed about 80 years ago. It's one of the few institutions in this country. The country itself is celebrating its 75th year of independence, right? So the CSIR was formed just 5 years before India became independent. So along with the CSIR, our country is also celebrating its 75th year, right? So this is a proud time. And first slide. So, are we ready? Am I audible? Okay. So, what I'm going to talk about is, what is the shape of Earth? You all know what is the shape of Earth? What is it? Some people may sound, says round. Some people may say geoid. Do you know what is the meaning of geoid? It's a Greek word. The meaning of geoid, if I translate that into English, earth-like. If I translate the word geoid into Tamil, Bhoomiyai pola. If I translate geoid into Hindi, it is Dharti ke tara. मैं आपसे पूछ रहा हूं धरती का आकार क्या है आप मुझे आंसर दे रहा है धरती के तरह वो आंसर है क्या நான் உங்கள்ட்ட வந்து பூமியோட வடிவம் என்னன்னு கேக்குறேன் நீங்க வந்து பூமியோட வடிவம் பூமி அப்படிን பதில் சொல்றீங்க அது பதிலாது அது ஏதோ ஒரு வேர்ட் மாதிரி இருக்கிறதுனால நம்ம ஏதோ பதில் மாதிரி நம்ம நினைக்கிறோம் we think that it is an answer because it looks like an answer Because it's a new word that we have not heard. So we think that it is the answer. If you translate that word, which is a Greek word, simple meaning is earth-like. Okay, forget it. My actual question is, how do you know that earth is spherical? Or shaped like a ball? How do you know it? Most of us would say, I read it in the textbook or my teacher told me. I want to tell you a small story. How I started giving a lecture like this. Okay. This happened around 10 years, 12 years ago. I was in Madurai, in the Madurai University. I was supposed to talk to the university students. That was in the afternoon. So in the morning, some of my friends said that there is a school here. So, and it's a Tamil school, so why don't you come and talk to them? So I went there. Then I was thinking, what should I talk, because I had not prepared anything. So I thought, okay, I will start with some question. Teacher ka ek kharab attitude hai na, all teachers ko question puchna. You know, all teachers have this bad habit, no? Question. Right? So I thought, okay, I will also ask question. So I asked this question. What is the shape of earth? It was a Tamil school. All of them stood up and said that vattam, round. Then I was thinking, what should I talk? So then I asked, how do you know that it is vattam or round? Then all of them stood up and said that our teacher told us. So the teachers were very happy. Okay. But is it actually an answer? Because how did the teacher know? Teacher's teacher told. How did that teacher know? Teacher. That's not an answer, no? Similarly, if it is in the book, how do you know that it is not a printing mistake? But how did the author come to know? He read it on the book. Then how did he come to know? She read it in some other. That can't be an answer, no? Yeah? So, the answer like my teacher told me, or it's there in the textbook, is not really an answer. So let me tell you a particular book. It's called Matsya Puran. Have you heard of it? Matsya Puran. In Tamil, people say it as Matsya Puran, Matsya Puranam. Okay. So according to this Puran, the shape of the earth is like a lotus flower. According to this Puran, the shape of the earth is like a lotus flower floating on a plate full of water. A circular plate that is full of water. One lotus flower, its petals are open. Okay, it's floating. Have you seen the seed pod of the lotus flower? It will look like an inverted triangle. In the center, the seed pod will be like an inverted triangle. Right? Yes. It will look like this. It will look like this. Inverted triangle. Okay? Like an inverted triangle, seed pod will be in the center. So according to this Puran, like a seed pod, the center of the earth has a mountain called Meru. Meru mountain, Meru Parvat, Meru Malai. Okay, so there is a mountain. And according to this Puran, how does the day and night occur? According to this Puran, the day and night occur. Let's assume this stage is the earth. I am the Meru mountain. Okay, let's assume this is the sun. The sun is going around the Mount Meru. So when the sun is here, what will happen to the land here? They will get sunlight. But what happened to the land here? They will be dark because it will be shadow, no? So night here. So when the sun comes here, this will become daytime and this will become? Yeah, good. So that is how Matsya Puran says earth is. So earth is flat, circular but flat. Not like a ball. Earth is flat. And there is a Meru mountain. So, there are different petals, right? So, one of the petals is called Bharata. Okay? Or Bharat. That is what, according to this Puran, what is India is. Okay? So, that's how the Vishnu Puran, Matsya Puran, they talk about the shape of it. We all have heard about the Meru Manthan. You know? They took the mountain, yeah, tied up a snake called Vasuki as a rope, and they did a Manthan, right? So we all have heard about this story. That same Meru Mountain. According to this Puran, the sun is going around the Mount Meru, and moon is above the Mount Meru. So, which means according to this Puran, sun is closer to earth compared to moon. And along with moon, there is 27 nakshatra. So, the moon is in the nakshatra mandala, which has 27 nakshatra. And then the remaining stars are called as tara. Okay, so this is how this Puran imagines the earth to be. Okay. Now you have two books. One is the Matsya Puran, other is your 7th standard science textbook. Matsya Puran says that earth is flat, circular. But our school book says earth is like a ball, spherical, which is true. How? How do you know? Then why do we study this science textbook? Okay. Now you can use satellite images to discover earth is spherical. But in olden days, okay, fine. So let me go forward. Yeah? Okay. So this was the question before Aryabhatta. Have you heard of Aryabhatta? In Tamil Nadu, we call him as Aryabhatta. In northern India, Aryabhatta. Okay? So whatever way it is, it doesn't matter. Aryabhatta or Aryabhatta. Okay? He is a person who lived about 1500 years ago. How many years ago? This year is 2021, right? He lived around 535 AD. Long back, 1500 years ago. Okay? There was no car, there was no bicycle. You know, he lived in those days, 1500 years ago. But then he had a question. What is the shape of earth? So he went to his friends and asked them, what is the shape of earth? Oh, they said that it's very well known. It's circular. There is a Mount Meru in the middle. Then he asked his friend, how do you know? They said, oh, our teacher told us. Oh, it is written in the book. But then Aryabhatta was not satisfied. He asked, how did your teacher know about this? Uska teacher bola hoga. He was not satisfied. He said, this is not answer. Okay? So then he said that I have to find the shape of earth. To find the shape of earth, you are standing on earth. Standing on earth to find the shape of earth, you need a yukti. If I want to find the shape of this flower vase, I can look at it because I am away from it, right? I can go different direction and I can look at it. But if I am standing on earth, I cannot see the shape of earth standing on earth, right? So then he thought, if I have to find the shape of earth standing on earth, I cannot go out because 1500 ago there was no rockets, there was no satellites. Right? So, how do I find? He said, I need a yukti. I need a trick. I need something very interesting. What did he do? He said, if I look at the shadow, somehow the shadow resembles the original object, right? Suppose right now there is sun outside. I go outside and I stand. I'll see a shadow, right? How will my shadow look like? Roughly me. Roughly my size. I mean, my shape, not size, my shape, right? Will not be exact, but lagbag. He said, this means I will solve the problem if I can see the shadow of earth. I don't need to see the earth itself from outside. I need to see only the shadow. If I see shadow, from the shadow I can guess what should be the shape of earth. Who said it? Aryabhatta. When does a shadow occur? Or when can you see the shadow? If there is a light source, and if there is an object, and if there is a screen. Okay, because the light source should fall on the object. This object should obstruct that light, and that light should fall on a screen. If it falls on a screen, then you will see the shadow, right? Yes. Suppose if there is a light coming from here, my shadow falls here. But if a light goes from here, and if I am in an open space, you can't see the shadow because there is no screen. Right? So you need three things for seeing shadow. A light source, the object, and a screen. Right? So then he thought, what is my light source? Sun. Sun is my light source. Good. My object, earth. Because I want to see the shadow of earth. What is the screen? The screen should be somewhere outside earth, no? Screen can't be on earth, right? So where is the screen? Maybe he scratched his head, we don't know. Okay? Maybe he scratched his head, we don't know. But then suddenly he got an idea. What happens during lunar eclipse? You have all studied in school, right? Lunar eclipse occurs when earth shadow. So now moon is my screen. Moon is my screen. On lunar eclipse, I can see the shadow of earth. Right? I can see the shadow of earth. And the shadow is falling on moon. Now let's look at it. This is the lunar eclipse. Yeah, here is the earth shadow. Can you look at this edge? Can you tell something about this edge? Think carefully. What is that edge shape like? What is that edge, shadow shape like? Okay, think carefully. So if you look at a lunar eclipse, initially, one edge of the moon, the shadow falls. Lunar eclipse occurs on full moon day, right? On Purnima. So one edge shadow falls. Then the shadow creeps and covers more portion. Then it creeps more and covers a larger area. So the moon looks like a crescent. Then it becomes even a smaller crescent, right? So this is how lunar eclipse occurs. Now let's look at each stage. The shadow is part of a circle. Technically called as arc of a circle, if you have studied that, right? So it's part of the circle. It's part of the circle. It's part of the circle. Right? So what do we know? No. The shadow of earth is light. Shadow of earth is? What is the shape of the shadow? Circle. We have found out, right? So, what is the first observation Aryabhatta made? At all stages of the eclipse, the shadow is an arc of a circle. No, I think don't put on the light. Forget the light. Oh, for the online. Oh, chacha, for me, for my light on me. And I'm also walking everywhere. Okay. Maybe I'll try to stand here. Fine. Okay. So you can see that at all stages of the eclipse, the shadow is a arc of a circle. Okay, so first thing that you have observed. Okay, so you know what is the shape of the shadow. Right? Now second thing what he did was, he calculated, if I have an arc, then I can draw the full circle. Right? I can draw the full circle. So when he drew the full circle, he found the full circle, the shadow circle, was 2.5 times the size of moon at all times. It means the shadow did not become smaller or bigger. It was constant. Constant, one same size, right, at all times. At all times the shadow is 2.5 times the width of moon. So two observations.
What is the first observation? So we know that Earth's shadow is circular. What is the second observation? It remains same size all through. It remains the same size. The shadow remains the same size all through. These are two things that we know. Now what can you conclude? From this, what can you conclude? You can conclude, first of all, Earth cannot be shaped like my mobile. Can you conclude that? Why? Because this mobile cannot produce a circular shadow. Right? So first thing that you can conclude is that Earth cannot be in this shape. Can Earth be triangle? Can Earth be rectangle? Square? Shoebox? Pyramid? So, first thing we do in science is reject a few things. We may not still know what is the shape of Earth, but in science we say that this is not possible. Okay? This is not possible. We may not still know at this stage if you have gone, if you can do time travel. 1500 years ago, you switch on, go back, meet Aryabhatta and ask Aryabhatta, what is the shape of Earth? Aryabhatta will say, oh, it is not triangle. It is not pyramid. But what is the shape of Earth? Oh, that I don't know. I'm yet to find out. You got it? Science progresses like that, step by step. Okay, so you know that it cannot be. Can it be a cylinder? Are you sure? Lock kar diya jaye. It can be. Can it be a ball? Can it be a cone? Can be. It can be any of these. It can be any of this. Can it be circular? Like a plate? Yes. Circular plate. Right? But out of this four, which is correct? We don't know. If you had asked Aryabhatta, you will say that I don't know. I have not found out. What I have found out is that it has to be only one of these four. A circular disc, a cone, a cylinder, or a ball. But certainly it is not a pyramid. Certainly it is not a shoebox size, cuboid. Right? It is not. It can be only this. Then you will ask Aryabhatta, if you have gone on, how do we found then the real shape of Earth? Aryabhatta will say that I need to find another yukti. This itself he got through one yukti, na? So you will say that let me think of another yukti. Okay. So now I need two of you to come to the stage. Fast. Two people. Develop. One. Two of you. Two. Only two. Let us assume this is the sun. Okay? This is the sun. Okay? This is the sun. Let's assume he is the earth. His head is the earth, not the whole body. Only the head is the earth. And let's all assume the nose tip is Chennai. And CLRA is here. Okay, what's your name?
Prithvi.
Huh? Prithvi. If I like look through telescope, I can see Prithvi here, standing here. What is this? CLRA. Okay. Now, Earth is like this. Exactly on top of CLRA is Sun. So what will be the time in CLRA? 12 o'clock night. 12 noon, right? Now Earth is like this. What will be the time in CLRI? 12 night, right? Clear? No problem? Clear? Now what will be the time? This was 12 o'clock noon. This was 12 o'clock night. Then what should be this time? 6 o'clock morning or evening? Evening. Evening 6 o'clock, correct? So this is night 12 o'clock. Then this will be what? 6 a.m., right? So now look at this. If I draw a line from sun to the center of earth to CLRI, what will be the angle? Straight line to the center of earth, that is center of his head to his nose, what will be the angle? Zero. This will be zero. This will be 180, right? This will be 180, this will be zero. So when the angle is zero, it is 12 noon. When the angle is 90, it is evening 6 o'clock. When the angle is 180, it is night 12 o'clock. When the angle is 270, morning 6 o'clock, right? When again angle becomes 0 or 360, it is noon. So time is nothing but angle. Angle between sun, center of earth, and your point in the sphere. That angle defines the time, right? Right? So now, this is moon. This is moon. Now, sun's earth shadow will fall on moon. Yeah? So this will be lunar eclipse. Okay? Correct? So when this lunar eclipse occurs, what is the time in CLRI? 12 noon. 12 noon, right? Okay. Then let's say many years go, okay, another lunar eclipse is occurring when Earth is like this. So when now lunar eclipse is occurring, what is the time in CLRI? 12 midnight, yeah? Let's say many years go and then another lunar eclipse occurs. What is the time now? But all times, Earth shadow falls on moon, and then what you are having? A circular shadow. So, whichever direction the Earth rotates, whichever direction is the Earth, the shadow is what?
Falling on the moon.
Not only that, what is the shape of the shadow?
Circular.
So, whatever be the direction, whatever be the orientation, the shadow is?
Circular,
right? Good, this we saw it, yeah? Thank you. So that is what Aryabhatta observed. So whatever be the time of occurrence of lunar eclipse, which means the orientation of Earth, the shadow is circular. Now, if Earth was a plate, if Earth was a plate, it makes a circular shadow. But if it turns, then is it circular? No. So Earth cannot be? Yeah. If Earth was a cylinder, if it turns, is it circular? So Earth cannot be same with cone, right? So what is the only shape where whichever is the direction of sunlight, the shadow is circular? Which is the only shape? It can't be a cylinder. It can't be cone. But the only shape which will produce circular shadow, whichever be the direction of sunlight, is what? So what should be the shape of Earth? That's how Aryabhatta found it. That's how Aryabhatta found that the shape of Earth is spherical. Yeah? So, science is not, it is not what, when, where. So, it is, science is not what is the shape of earth. Science is, how do we know that it is spherical? Why do we, why are we so certain that it is spherical? That is science. Got it? So, science is not? Science is? How and why. Okay? So, to really understand science, we need to ask this question, how and why. Let me go a bit. Let's understand Aristotle. Have you heard of Aristotle? Okay. So, Aristotle also found the shape of earth. But he used a completely different yukti. What was his yukti? What Aristotle did is, he went to a seashore and he stood on the seashore. And he observed a ship going away from the seashore. When the ship was here, it was looking like this. When the ship went here, he was able to see only the sails, not the bottom part. When the ship went here, he was able to see only the flag, not the rest of the ship. Why? Yeah? Okay. Can one of you come here? One of you? Yeah, she. Yeah, you come. Yeah. You stand here. I am Aristotle. She is the ship. So the ship is now going to go away from the shore. And the ship will go. Wait. After I tell you, the ship will go and go through the step one by one. Okay? One by one. So ship go. So ship becomes smaller. Ship go. Ship will become smaller. Ship go. It will become even smaller. Okay, bit more. Yeah, it will become even smaller and smaller. Go to one step below. The steps. Steps. Now I cannot see the shoe of that ship. Yeah, because it's curved. Okay, go one step. Now I cannot see the knee. Yeah, go one step. Now I cannot see below chest. Okay, so because the earth is curved. Thank you, Mom. Thank you. Because earth is curved, when the ship is going away from the shore, it will become smaller and smaller and smaller. Not only that, part of the ship will be disappearing from the bottom up. And after some time, the whole ship will be disappearing. Okay? So from this, what did Aristotle say? Yet should be curved. And then he went to Ireland. Island surrounded by ocean. He stood on top of a mountain and said, let ship go in all directions. So in all directions he found the same phenomena. So from that, what can you conclude? Earth should be curved on all directions. So if it is curved on all directions, it should be a sphere. Right? So this is what you can see. Actual photograph. When the ship is near the shore, when the ship is far away from the shore. And here you see like containers are floating on water because you are not seeing the bottom of the ship at all. Right? So, earth is spherical. So, Aristotle found that earth is spherical by a different yukti, not like Aryabhatta. So, whether you are Aryabhatta or Aristotle, science converge because we are talking about reality, truth, reality, right? So, whether I see it or you see it, it should be same for me, for you, for somebody in Africa, for somebody in Australia, everyone, even if there is somebody in another planet, A plus B whole square is? A square plus B square plus 2AB, right? Even if there is another planet and people living in that another planet. the sum of the angles of Euclidean triangle is 180 degree, right? It should be true for everyone, right? So truth is true for everyone, right? Do we have time? Am I boring you? Are you enjoying it? I want you to say it loudly. Only then I will believe. Now I am going to tell you a third guy who found the shape of Earth. Do you want to listen to it? Okay. So this guy's name is Jnanaraja. He lived in 1500 AD. He lived in? That is 500 years ago. Aryabhatta lived 1500 years ago. But Jnanaraja lived 500 years ago. Okay, 1500 AD. So he wrote a book called Siddhanta Sundara. The beautiful Siddhanta or treatise. Okay, that is the title of his book. So in that book, he not only shows that Earth is spherical, but also he computes what is the shape, what is the size of Earth. Not only shape, size, how big it is. Do you want to understand? Ready? Sound. Good. Have you heard of something called as a pole star? Okay. Let's say, for example, pole star is there. Okay. Pole star is there. That means that is north. Okay. If that is north, this should be east, right? Right. So I am in the west. I am a traveler. I am traveling from west to east. I am traveling from west to east. I see the pole star. Pole star is above the horizon. Let us say, if I see from Chennai, I will see it around 8 degrees above the horizon. Okay, Chennai is, I think, 8 degree east or 10 degree east. I forgot. Okay. Around 8 degrees or something above the horizon. Okay. So, when I am here, it is 8 degree. I travel west, it's still 8 degree. I'll travel even more west, it's still 8 degree. First observation. So when I travel east-west, the elevation of pole star does not change. Okay? The elevation does not change. Now, from south, I'm going towards north. Okay? When I'm going from south to north, the pole star seems to go up. Okay? Pole star seems to go up. Okay? So, yeah, so this observation let's take. Have you seen that moon sometimes seems to walk with you? Why? Because it likes you. Right? It wants to take a walk with you. You know? Okay. That is poetry. Let's understand science. Why the moon appears to walk with you? Let's say I am a bus. A traveler in a bus, okay? And this, let us say, this table is the one telegraphic pole, telephone pole, okay? So the bus is here, I am looking at the window, and then I turn my head, I see the pole, okay? But when the bus is moving, my angle becomes, right? Here it was this much angle. The angle is getting reduced, okay? So it becomes 90 degree, right? And then when I move forward, angle changes, correct? So I have to turn my head to see the pole. But suppose if I'm going at a far distance, the angle is here, the angle change is less, right? So if I'm here, I turn only this much, but if I am here, I have to turn this much to see it, right? So when I am far away, the angle change is very small. If I was even more far away, what will happen? The angle change will be even less, If I was really very far away, I won't perceive it. So when I don't perceive it, what will it appear as? It's also moving along with me. Right? So because I'm sitting in a window and watching, I see the moon, my bus is moving, the moon will also be moving. But whereas all the nearby objects will be seeming to go back. Right? So that's why moon appears to walk with you. Right? So when I see pole star like that, and when I move east-west, the pole star also moves with me, right? So which means what? Pole star should be really far away. Right? So this is something that we can decide. Second observation, instead of moving west to east, if I move from south to north, the elevation of the pole star goes up. Right? These two observations. So if I am standing on the pole star is on top of me. Okay? If I am standing on equator, the pole star is on the horizon. So if I am standing somewhere at between these equator and pole, then the angle of pole star is 45 degrees. Okay? So from equator to pole, the angle changes from 0 to 90. Right? So this means if the pole star should be very far, yet should be curved, only then you will get these angles. So from this you can conclude that yet should be spherical, like a ball. Okay? It should be spherical like a ball. Next, what Gyanaraja did was one more step forward. What he said was that if I travel 14 yojana, yojana is like a measurement, like we use meter, kilometer, mile, right? So like that, in those days, they used to use a measurement called yojana. So if I move 14 yojana north, the pole star goes by 1 degree. If I move 14 yojana, the pole star goes by 1 degree. So which means, for 1 degree, it is 14 yojana. So for 316, what should be the distance? So it's a ratio, right? Something that we have studied in our school. Ratio proportions, right? 1 is to 14 is equal to 360 into C. So find C. So if I want to find C, C equal to 14 into 360, which is 5040 yojana. But this 5040 yojana is the circumference of the earth, right? Circumference of the earth. So 2 pi r is 540. So which means r is 802 yojana. So the radius of earth is 802 yojana. So simply sitting at a place by this observation, you calculated the size of earth. Okay? You calculate the size of earth. Okay? So, which also means from the pole star to equator, the distance is 2520 yojana. So, that also you can conclude. But then Gyanaraja did one thing more. That is why we want to specially talk about him. What he did? He made all this calculation. Good. Looks very logical. Good. But can we be very certain about it? That's a question that Gyanaraja asked. He said, no, we need to perform an experiment to check if it is true. So what is the experiment he prepared? He said, if earth is spherical, if I start from Rajasthan, where he was, if I cross the equator, then I should not be able to see the pole star. Because earth is spherical, you are in this side, pole star is here, you can see. If you go this side, you can't see this, right? Yeah, you can't see the pole star, right? So if I cross equator, I should not be able to see the pole star. So he said that let's perform that experiment. He said that let's perform the experiment. So he told the king. So the king sent a Muslim sailors to go on ocean voyage. Okay, so they crossed the equator because they had calculated how much distance you have to go. So they moved that distance and they found that you cannot see the pole star once you cross the equator. So from this you can conclude with a reasonable justification that Earth is not only spherical but also roughly this size that Gyanaraja found, right? So that's when Earth became a globe. So you can find that Emperor Jahangir is holding a spherical Earth. So they concluded that Earth should be spherical. But is Earth really spherical? Newton said no. Earth is not exactly like a ball, more like a orange, on top and bottom, flat. Okay, so he gave a proof that why it should be, top and bottom should be flat, right? Now we have sent some satellites. So when the satellite go around the Earth, okay, if there is a mountain, because of the mountain there will be more gravity, right? So the satellite will be pulled. If you are in ocean and a deep ocean, there will be less mass, okay, so the satellite will go up. So from this movement of the satellite, you can now find the shape of the Earth is not really spherical. Okay, it's not exactly spherical. We know even better. Okay, we can measure the gravitational potential. Okay, what does it mean? It means science will always grow. Science will always progress. We know something roughly. We will know even more better. After some time, we will know even more better. Like that, the science will constantly progress. Okay, many people have problem with it. They think that yesterday you told like this. Because yesterday we knew only so much. Today we know some more. So our understanding becomes even better. Right? So that's how science changes over a period of time. So let's come to the title of our talk. What was the title of this talk? How? So let's ask that question again. So how did he found the shape of Earth? First, because he dared to ask the question. He did not believe because people told. He said that, no, I want to understand why. Why that is true. He was ready. So he was ready to question. Second, he did not accept what others told. Right? Third, he wanted scientific evidence, observation, inference. Okay, there is no supernatural. Right? So if you read Aryabhatiyam, Aryabhata writes in Aryabhatiyam how he found all this. He says that there is an ocean of truth and false knowledge. There is also false knowledge because people believe wrong things, right? So in this ocean, I jumped and I picked out few truths. He says, I did not pick out every truth. There are a lot of things we don't know. I picked up few truths by Swamati. That is the word he is using. Swamati means my own intelligence. That is my own thinking. My own rational thoughts. That's how I found. He writes in his Aryabhatiyam. And that's why even today, after 1500 years, all over the world, not just in India, everyone is fascinated about Aryabhata and his research. Right? So one of the important questions that we should ask ourselves is, how do we know? When we say we know something, we should be able to answer how we acquired that knowledge, why that claim is reliable. Okay, so these are two things that we need to understand. So you need to put thinking cap, not just believe what some other person says. So we should think why this claim is true. What evidences force me to accept that this claim is true, right? To be scientifically literate is to empower yourself to know when someone else is full of bullshit. That is when somebody is just telling you some wrong things and then make you want to believe it, right? Or do you know who is this guy? Okay. His name is Richard Feynman. Richard Feynman, you are all Google generation, so Google his name. Richard Feynman, one of the finest physicists of last century. I mean, we are still in 21st century, so 20th century. So he is saying, what is science? Science is not a way of fooling ourselves. So if you don't want to fool yourself, you need to follow science. And that is why in India, in our constitution, we are saying it's a duty of every Indian citizen to promote scientific temper. Okay? This institution is one of such a fine institution that has been found with that sentiment, which has driven our national movement, freedom movement. And on this day, I'm very happy to have given this talk to you. Thank you. So I'll take any questions, comments. Thank you. So was it nice, understandable? Good. Thank you. I think audible, yeah?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the matter is simple. That's how I demonstrated here, right, with the two kids?
No, sir.
So here is the sun, there is the earth, okay, and there is a moon. Suppose if I am in a position where Aryabhatta was, okay, Aryabhatta was supposed to have been in either Kanjipuram or Patna. There are two claims. Whichever it is, you know the lunar eclipse, okay? And in that lunar eclipse, it occurs at different times. It doesn't occur at same time every time, right? And you know the angle of sun. In the morning sun is at the horizon. At the noon sun is on top of you. So you can calculate the angles. So from that, actually you found that it should be the your place and the sun, that angle should be changing. That is how the time occurs.
No, sir, I want to ask, like, how he know that Earth is changing its angles or orientation? Earth may be static also, no?
Which one is static? That is, the Earth should be static.
Yes.
Doesn't matter, no? Then at least sun should be moving, right?
Okay.
So that's what I said. Whichever direction the sun source of light is, it doesn't matter that I did not show here, okay. You can also take the Earth, sun is moving. Mm-hmm. So if the sun is moving and sun is here, the moon should be here.
Yes.
Right? So doesn't matter, right? So it's any angle. Whether Earth is rotating on its own or whether the sun is rotating Earth, it's only angle. So for that particular part, it's only the angle that matters. No?
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
See, it's a very simple thing, right? If the sun is at horizon, it's daytime. If the sun is at around 90 degree, it is noon. When the sun is at 180 degree, it's dusk. Then after that, when the sun is going to be below your
like it is going to be night 12 o'clock.
Excuse
me? Any angle, whichever way you look at it. Yeah? Uh-huh.
My doubt is that why does the sun have to stay at one place? Why can't the sun move like the earth?
Good. What's your name?
Naba.
Naba, very good. Naba, sun is also moving. Okay, it's like this. Sit. Where are you from?
CLRA only.
Yeah?
CLRA only.
Yeah, CLRA, but otherwise your parents?
Nishar Fatima.
Yeah?
Nishar
Chennai, Fatima. Chennai. They are also in Chennai.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, fine. You were born, brought up, everything in Chennai. Your parents also Chennai. Okay, very good. Let me say like this. Suppose you want to go for a vacation. Naba, where have you gone? Outside Chennai, where have you gone?
I have gone to many countries. I don't know.
No, some place in India other than Chennai.
Some place in India.
Any place that you have gone in train?
Kerala.
Okay, you have gone in train, right?
Yeah.
So you are sitting in the train, okay? Your mummy is sitting opposite to you.
Yeah.
Okay. So you both are sleeping in the night.
Okay.
Are you moving or are you not moving?
I don't know. I think I do move.
Okay. So the question is that if I ask the question to somebody who is sitting next to you, they will say, no, they are not moving. They are sleeping in the same berth. Right? Inside the train. But somebody standing outside the train, they will say, oh, that fellow is moving some 80 kilometers per hour. Right? So in the same way, if we look at sun as stationary, earth is moving around the sun. But then if you go outside, the earth, sun, everything itself is moving. You understand? You are moving with the train. Okay? The earth, sun, everything is moving.
Okay.
So sun is also moving. There is nothing in this universe which is not moving.
No, my doubt was that why is the sun moving?
Okay. Why the sun is moving is, when you ask the question why, it's usually about purpose. Why do you eat? Because you are feeling hungry. Why do you comb your hair? Otherwise you look untidy, right? So why is a question for human being? Okay, why a stone is there? Stone doesn't want to be there. So in science, that's why we ask another question, how? So how the sun is moving? How the earth is moving? Earth is moving around the sun because there is a gravitational force which is making the earth move around. Similarly, our galaxy has a gravitational force because of which sun is moving around. Okay. So, actually, why is not a good question for inanimate objects? Because they don't have any purpose.
Okay.
Why is a question for human being? Why do I study? Why do I eat? Why do I read? Why do I sleep? Okay, you have an answer. But why is there a cloud? The cloud is not interested in being there. It is just there.
Yeah.
How the cloud is there? You can answer. There is a pond here. It's a summer, the pond water is evaporating, it has become a cloud.
Okay.
Yeah. There is a movement of both clouds and the moon. The moon is also shifting its position because in the evening, for example, on a Purnima day, when the sun is setting, the moon will be rising, right? And the moon's position will change in the sky. It will be rising and setting, right? So there is also a apparent movement of moon. Then cloud is also moving. So the combined thing, you are experiencing a particular way. Yeah. Okay. prime meridian is at the center of the earth? That is the question that has been asked. Well, for example, if you are looking at center of the earth, earth is a ball-like structure, so center is somewhere inside. Okay, so the prime meridian cannot be center of the earth. So if you are saying that if the prime meridian is the center of the surface of earth, which are two different things, it is only convention. There is no reason that the prime meridian is the center of the surface of earth. There is no reason. It is something that we accept as a convention to start with. That's all. For example, why do we say that your day starts at night at 12 o'clock? You can also say that the day starts when the sun is rising. Okay, so it's only convention that we take night 12 o'clock as the birth of a new date in modern times. Right, so that way it's only a convention. There is no, it's not necessary that the prime meridian should have been the prime meridian. It could have been something else also. Okay, what is the shape of the universe? R.C. Panda is asking. Excellent, Panda, it's a very great question. Suppose if I know the answer for this, I will immediately book my ticket to Stockholm for coming December, because then I will be given Nobel Prize. We don't know answer to this question. Okay? Why I am saying this with so much pleasure, I want to tell you here one thing, one small story. When I started doing my research, my teacher came to the first class and told me, if you want to be a good scientist, you should know 1, 4, 4. What you should know? 1, 4, 4. We were all very young kids at the time, so we all shouted, sir, it's not 1, 4, 4. It is 1, 4, 3. Do you know what is 1, 4, 3? 1 is I, 3 is U. Then what should be 4? Do you know what is 1, 4, 3? 1 is I, 3 is U, Y-O-U, 3. I love you. So we were all shouting, no sir. He said, no, 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 that is for something else. If you want to be a scientist, you should be 1, 4, 4. Then we asked him, what is it? He said that, I don't know. He told me that, told us that, I don't know. Then he also told about one film. It's Kung Fu Master, if I remember correct. So in that, there'll be one scenario. So this fellow will say that, I know all karate, kung fu, etc. Then he will go to learn from a master. The master will give him a full glass of water and say that, pour water, but without spilling. He said, no, I can't pour. So he'll say that, if you think yourself that you know everything, you will never learn anything new. Okay, so you have to start with the point that maybe I don't know many things. Then you will start learning. So for this question, I want to appreciate Panda. Ask this question, find some answer, you may get Nobel Prize. We are old, we won't get, but you may get. Carry on. Yeah. Sir, we know that our moon is moving 4 centimeters away from Earth. Come down, then we'll go to the other one. As same as Earth and Jupiter as moons, even today, they move away. Okay. First thing, I'll explain what he is saying. Do you know that our moon is moving away about 3 centimeters every year away from us? Once upon a time, moon was very close to Earth. That time, the Earth was making one rotation in about 8 hours. So one day was only 8 hours. So you get up, brush, take bath, day over. Yeah? So now it has become 24 hours. Wait for another 500 crore years, only 500 crore years. Earth will take 30 days to go around itself once. So 1 month will be 1 day. Because the moon would have gone so much away from Earth, Earth will slow down. Okay? This is happening in Earth. So his question is, Jupiter has many moons. What's happening there? there are two kinds of action in this solar system that is happening to all planets and satellites. One, like moon, they are going away. Or like Earth and Sun, they are coming together. Earth is not going away from Sun. Earth is going towards the Sun. Okay, so these are the two kinds of action. So if you look at the satellites of Jupiter, each one of them is either of this. Either they are going away from Jupiter or they are falling towards Jupiter. Okay, so each one of them have different, Srihari, what is the size of a black hole? Okay, the size of black holes can be many things, because there are people are talking about black hole the size of atom to black holes the size of few kilometers. Okay, so the black holes can have many different sizes depending on the mass of the black hole. Okay, so it can have many different. Every day the sea level is rising. What will happen to the future? It's an important question in today's time. We are told around 20% of world population live within a few kilometers of sea. Within, I think, 20 kilometers of sea, 20% of the world population live. So if the sea level rises, huge population around the world will be affected. Climate change is the important reason for the sea level rise. And climate change is driven by increase in carbon dioxide in atmosphere, which is essentially caused by use of fossil fuel, petroleum and that kind of fuel. So we need alternatives. We need to look at fusion energy. We need to look at green energies like solar energy. Okay, so that's the future. Okay.
I really like the way you simply explained. The question is, this is Sashia from Aurangabad, Maharashtra. My question is, while sunset, why do we always see the sun going down and up when sunrise?
Okay, fine. So, Sashya, it's an interesting question. The sunrise is sunrise, so sun should be rising. Sunset is set, so it should be setting. So there is no wonder there. But essentially, your question is very simple. See, basically, during sunrise, our point in the earth, okay, the point where you are standing or I am standing, is moving toward the sun. So we are moving toward the sun, so it appears that moon is rising. And at the sun's set, we are moving away from the sun, so it appears like it is setting. Okay, so it's both are only appearance. They are not really sun is not rising, really sun is not setting. Sun is at one place, earth is rotating, right? So our part of the earth is moving towards the sun, then it appears like rising. When it is moving away from sun, it appears like setting. Okay, so here Srikanth Venkatesh has a question from Bangalore. Can an equilibrium be maintained where no objects move away or move towards each other? No, you cannot maintain in a real world. You can maintain that only in theoretical conditions. Why it cannot be maintained in real world is very simple. If you take Earth, Earth is a mass object whose mass is not evenly distributed. Okay, some part of the Earth has more mass, some part of the Earth has less mass. Same with the Moon. Okay, so no object will have a perfectly equally distributed mass. So because of that, when they rotate, different parts, when they come towards each other, there'll be small gravitational perturbations, and that's what makes the objects either fall towards or spiral out, one of these. So perfect equilibrium is not possible in real life world. Very excellent question. Okay. That's a very excellent question. So I'll repeat the question. One is that we talk about stars being many times size of Earth, I mean many times size of the Sun. How do we know the size? Okay. There are two methodologies which are used. When the stars are near to us, like there is a star called Betelgeuse, or in India we call it as Adra. Okay. In Tamil we call it as Thiruvadirai. Okay. That star is supposed to be many times bigger than Sun. That star actually we can see through a telescope. So we can measure its arc. And we know the distance. From that we can calculate its size. Okay. So when we calculate all this, this is all with the margin of error. Okay. It's not perfect. So it's with margin of error. So some of the nearby stars we can calculate the size like this. When the stars are very far away, we use an indirect method. The indirect method is that we know what is the temperature of that star from its spectrum. We also know what color it's shining, where the maximum energy is coming. So we estimate that what should be the size of that object to have that surface temperature. Okay, so then it should be that bigger or this small to emit that surface temperature and that much of luminescence. Okay, so that's how it's calculated. There it's calculated. That's how estimates are made. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So we can today calculate the lunar and solar eclipse very accurately. That's fine. In the ancient time, how did they calculate? Ancient time, they calculated by, because all of these are some kind of periodic events. For example, we can calculate that almost every 29.5 days, you will have Amavasya. Every 29.5 days, you will have a Purnima, because it's a periodicity. So in the same way, the eclipses are also a kind of a periodic phenomena. So you can calculate that period, and from that period, you can calculate that when it is going to occur. In fact, if you look at solar eclipse, people will say that this is the this series solar eclipse, because that's one period. Then they will say that this is this series solar eclipse, because that is one period. Okay, so that periods are what is used for calculating solar and lunar eclipse. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. That's so wonderful. It makes me want to go back to school, actually. It's so nice, sir. Before we wrap up, director would like to say a few words. I request the director to address the gathering.
I would actually say that the CSIR Foundation Day was totally different in CLRA. For every CSIR Foundation Day, we used to have some high-flying scientist come and talk about something which even the scientists would half understand and all that. But today, in CLRA, we made all the difference. Thank you, sir, for that. And I must say that we should also thank COVID, because the chat box questions were not actually, some of them were not even coming from Chennai. It was coming from places like Aurangabad and Bangalore and all that kind of stuff, which is only possible in this mode of communication. Otherwise, a few of us will be sitting here. If no questions was asked from within the hall, we always say there's only two ways. You understood everything or you didn't understand anything, the second one being more true. But today was a tremendous day. And I must say that we should all put our hands together one more time for the speaker for that excellent talk. So thank you very much. This is a small announcement. Actually, it's not for those who are on the webinar or the telecast. It's for all of you who are in the campus. Post your midterm exams, we will be opening up the playgrounds once again, assuming that you would follow the COVID guidelines and ensure that you will all remain safe in the campus. Okay, we had locked up the playgrounds, etc., for some time because of the COVID spread. Now, once again, we will open it up, but please ensure that you follow all the COVID guidelines when you are playing around. Okay? If anything more happens again, one more COVID, we will close it again. Right? And here itself, I find you, some of you are not sitting with your masks on. You will be starting to go to the school. So please be on with your masks. Right? We are all have already, you know, before entering, we used to tell all these staff members, are you doubly vaccinated? Then you can enter into the hall. So we have all got doubly vaccinated. So the requirement of having, if we get a COVID, going to the hospital being very less, you guys are more prone. Right? So please take care of yourself. So please act smart, act carefully, and enjoy the campus. Right? Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Our director has summarized this entire event by saying that it was really a lecture which went to the hearts of the audience, not only the virtual real audience, but as well as the virtual audience. He has said in one sentence, and on above that, I would like to thank our guest speaker, Dr. T.V. Venkateswaran. Like I said, he made me want me to go back to school. It was such a nice lecture. Hearing from you, sir, it's truly an experience, and I hope you keep coming back to us. We would have more students here. Due to COVID restrictions, we were not inviting many of the students from outside the campus. So furthermore, when there are more relaxations, I'm sure we'll have more students, and many of them would like to hear more from you, sir. We are very thankful to you, sir. And on behalf of the 80th CSIR Foundation Day Organizing Committee, on behalf of the director and on behalf of all the staff, I request your director to give a small memento to the guest speaker. Thank you, sir. On this occasion, the CSIR Foundation Day is on today, and we have many more events coming up later, and I'm sure you'll all be a part of it. I would like to thank, before that, many of the infrastructural facilities extended by our CLRI, and primarily I would like to thank our director, Dr. K.J. Sriram, for having constituted a committee to steer this entire event, and also the chairman of the steering committee, Dr. K.C. Velappan, and his team of scientists who guided and conducted this these events in a very amicable way. It started with a young scientist seminar, virtual mode. Dr. Suguna Lakshmi takes a credit for this, fellow scientists. And then we had the essay writing competition and the drawing and painting competition. And Dr. Fani Kumar and his team take credit for this. We had the quiz competition. We have our section officer and the AO to take credit for this. Then we have the Rangoli contest this morning. It was really interesting. Despite the drizzle, it didn't deter the participants to come and participate in large numbers. You should actually go and take a look at it. The Rangoli competition was held in the Skill Development Center at the just behind the new Caters building. It is going to be open today and tomorrow. So people interested to have a look at those can directly go and have a look at that. And please be careful, please don't disturb it, because if you all rush in, no, it might get spoiled. So be careful and do it. And I would like to thank all the support staff and the people who actually gave the support in conducting this event, the lab maintenance, the electrical, the instrumentation, the canteen, and one and all. Thank you, sir. Thank you, one and all. Milkshakes have been given to you without the straw. That is because we didn't want you to miss out on the milkshakes, but then we didn't want you to have it inside the auditorium. So as you move outside, you'll be given the straws. Please have them, enjoy it. Okay? Thank you, one and all. Shall we raise for the national anthem?
चंद्र को जला।